we can.
It's me, Big Daddy G, and things are about to get lit. A wise man once said, if you want to find out what drives the human spirit, get a person to eat weird flavoured ice cream or collect sand in a shopping trolley. That man, none other than Nelson Mandela. And before you start writing in, I'm talking about the Nelson Mandela who owns the laundrette in my hometown. And he did say that, and once I saw him eat 40 bags of hula hoops in one sitting. Guy's a legend. Who are the five whose spirits we look to test? Well, please welcome Dara Breen! Fern Brady! John Kearns! Munya Chihuahua! And Sarah Millican! And next to me, he's got a brain made for business and a bod made for sin. Are you in a good mood?
I'm in a good mood. Well, I'm in charge of health and safety concerns now. I've got a new hard hat, just in case. Here it is. Here it is. You can see there. It's got straps there. And there's a zip there. I don't know how you put it on, actually. It's such a hard... Such a...
That's it. That's the joke, is it?
It's a hard hat.
It's a hard hat to put on.
Such a hard hat to put on.
Yeah. You know, some of these people have travelled quite some distance.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, I'm on the prize task.
On we go, and this time the category is the thing you would most like to have with you on a car journey. Hmm, a car would be pretty handy.
Get the hat out again, party time!
The item Greg agrees is best for a car journey will get its owner 5 points, and the winner of the show will scoop up all 5 things and have a ridiculously good drive home from studio.
Dara, what is the thing you would most like to have with you on a car journey?
I have gone for this case.
It's a console carrying case, and here it is.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
You can strap any gaming machine to it, plug it in and play full-size video games or watch a movie if you want.
I mean, they're not famously portable, are they?
But this makes them portable.
And that's why when you're on tour, you only wear one outfit because you have to put all your energy into carrying this one. Fern, can you beat a massively impractical games console holder?
Oh, yes, mine's is very practical. If you're a comedian, one of the things you need other than resilience and being emotionally dead inside is the skill of holding in your piss for long amounts of time on car journeys. So I've brought a Shiwi. I think there's... available. I think there's one called a Go Girl. I asked for a bottle that was about 2 litres so I can keep driving.
Oh! I don't think I'd fully understood the scenario here. You're driving and wanting not to stop.
Yes.
Why?
I haven't got the confidence to use mine and I've for a year.
You should try it just at home in the toilet, because I got one. As soon as I got it, I thought, I'm going to have a go at this. So I had a little try, and I got a little bit on the seat like a real live boy.
John?
I brought in...
there we go.
A sailor's hat.
Yep.
Picture it, yeah?
I am picturing it.
You're driving along.
Yep.
You see a car beside you.
Mm-hmm.
You look over at the driver, he's wearing that. Everyone's honking. Everyone loves him. You're thinking, you know, is he late for his boat? Kids banging on the window, going, yeah!
Are the kids these days excited by a small bearded man in a sailor hat? Just imagine Alex and I are in a car journey now. I'm driving, obviously. Yeah. He's sitting there eating crisps.
Yeah.
This is what I perceive to be my reaction.
Okay.
Look at this prick. Monia, what have you brought in?
I brought in a coordination game.
Here it is.
Shit.
This device can measure human IQ by how quickly you can line up the discs. Now, if I can do this in 8 seconds on the show, Greg,
yeah,
you're going to give me 5 points.
I don't know, possibly.
But you're not in a car.
We're in a car. John's my passenger. Right, talk to me.
Have you seen the?
Yeah. Okay.
Have you seen where I put my sailors at?
Yeah.
Look out for the central reservation.
Okay, swerving. Okay. Yeah.
So you failed.
No. Hang on.
As a multiple car pilot. That's got to be the worst prize I've seen. That is going to get beaten by a fucking sailor. Imagine that. Just for health and safety reasons.
So I watched a TV programme where somebody drove accidentally, obviously, into some water and they drowned. Drama, don't worry, nobody knows, just actors. So I went online and thought there's got to be something that would help you in that situation, and I bought an escape hammer. The red part is the hammer itself.
Yep.
The bit at the end slices through your seatbelt, because that's a problem, you get locked in. And the bit at the end can tap out your windscreen. You are welcome.
It's a fairly pessimistic thing to take with you, isn't it?
It's not. I think it's positive. If it was pessimistic, I would just be like, well, dead now.
Oh, Christ.
Yeah, difficult to judge.
Well, one of them isn't difficult. Give me 1 point. And then, obviously, Captain Ahoy, 2 points. I must give Dara 3 points.
Right.
Fern with 4 points.
OK.
Sarah Millican, 5 points.
There we go. Sarah Millican wins.
Let's have a task proper then, shall we?
OK, we begin this one in the garage.
Yo, is that Alex Horn on my lawn eating corn at the crack of dawn? Oi, oi, oi.
Oh. Whoa!
Bloody hell. Choose a room.
And a weapon.
Then await further instructions.
Choose a room in the Taskmaster house.
And a weapon.
Right, let's have a look.
Shed, lab, kitchen, living room, loo, caravan.
The weapons are a frying pan.
Belt.
A high heel shoe.
A staple gun.
Cactus.
I'm going to go for the traditional frying pan.
Okay.
In the lab. Oh, there's no hiding places. In the living room.
And I'm going to go with the frying pan in the warmest room in the house. The living room.
Good old frying pan. It's got a good swing on it. And I'm going to go to the living room, please. Alex?
I choose kitchen and cactus.
Can I ask you why?
I like being in the kitchen. And then I picked the cactus instead of the frying pan because I wanted to be unpredictable.
I'll go with the belt.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I'm going to go in... well, again, if I'm being attacked, I have to, you know, really maim whoever's attacking me. I need to be, like, contained. I'm going to go in the caravan.
OK.
Good, so most people opting for a frying pan in the living room,
mm-hmm.
but John Kearns being the only person who seems to think that this task might involve, and I quote, maiming someone.
I did think we'd be maiming someone, to be fair.
Yes. Let's see if there's any maiming involved.
OK, well, first up, we're going to start with the lounge lizards. It's Munya, Sarah and Dara.
Ha-ha! What dangers await? Oh, no.
Oh. Okay, this was a bad choice.
Alex, I've got a fear of balloons popping.
I'm either supposed to burst them all or not burst any. So let's assume not burst any till we get to it.
Oh, well, there you go. Pop 99 red balloons.
You must use your weapon to pop your 99 red balloons.
Shout stop it when you think you've popped precisely 99 red balloons.
Fastest wins.
Your time starts now.
If I shout out the number, you do like a 5-bar gate for me. Is that okay?
I love doing 5-bar gates.
I can see that about you.
Yeah, I did that when I was in prison.
Okay.
Okay. Jesus!
There we go. One, two, three.
Ah, fuck.
10, 11, 12.
I need to.
Do you want earplugs, man? Yeah?
Huh?
Do you want earplugs?
I can't hear you, Alex.
Okay.
Oh, you made me lose count! Ah!
Am I 60? Like, I think I'm 60?
Yes, yeah, doing yeah. Do the gates.
I know there's exactly 99 in here. Oh.
85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90.
Stop it! That was full on, Dara. You meant to do something at the end.
Oh. Oh, stop it!
I've stopped the clock. Thank you, Sarah.
Stop it! I think I did really well.
Yeah.
One year, when I was at school, there was always a kid at school, when you played army, was just playing it on his own, really. It was playing, like, the storming forces and the victims, so he's going... That's you, Monya.
He's got a genuine balloon-popping phobia, though, so he did surmount that for this challenge.
Have you really?
Yeah. I was like, you know what? This isn't just a task anymore. This is personal development.
Yeah. And he burst all the balloons in that room.
Did he?
Yeah.
For the 99, though.
There were 111 in that room.
Oh. By stark contrast, Sarah, you made a conscious decision that you were going to do this physical task whilst not leaving the comfort of the sofa.
I chose the living room is because it was lovely and warm and comfy. I'm not going to not sit on the sofa for a bit of it. But it was absolutely joyous.
You look like you're having a lovely time. Dara, I think, took it a bit more seriously.
Oh, I went hell for leather.
Yeah.
Fuck those balloons.
At the very end, there's a still of you where you look like a Roman warrior who's just come from the battle. Give it 100 years, there's going to be a statue of that somewhere.
He was so quick. He did it in 3:20 compared to 5:02 for Sarah. Mm. Not terribly slow, but 9:25 for Munya.
What?
Unfortunately, Munya didn't do what we asked him to do. Can I show you something else?
This doesn't sound good.
85, 86, 87, 88, 80. Come on. 88, 89, 90.
You're supposed
to be counting with me!
Yeah.
Traitor!
Yes. You did... tell me to do the 5-bar gates and I did it, and then that happened and I didn't know what to do and I panicked and you didn't do it right.
Well, it looks like we've found our victim. Okay, time to close the curtains on part one. Why not go onto social media and pretend you're living your best life instead of doing a big Trump through your already compromised pyjamas? See you back here soon. Part two of Taskmaster. I'm going to hand straight over now to my little assistant, little Alex Horn.
The current task involves popping 99 balloons in the fastest time in the room of their choice with the weapon of their choice. Dara, Sarah and Munya did it in the living room with a frying pan. Only two people left. It's Fern with a cactus in the kitchen, which is lovely to say, and John in the caravan with a belt. Yuck. Here's how they got on. The clock has started, Fern.
Well, I'll just get going then.
Okay. Good luck.
That's not gonna work, is it?
bums.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
8, 9, 10.
1. I've stopped the clock.
Fern, I think I've written this down correctly. You were holding the balloons by their little bums.
The sort of anus part of the balloon.
The bit we all put our lips to.
Yeah.
You were trying to count as you went along, but you went up, down, you went all over the place with the numbers. So, yeah, you did, unfortunately, like Manya and Sarah, burst way too many balloons.
Oh.
John, I feel like with you we change genre from Dara's epic film about a Roman warrior to just a horror film of a... just an awful lunatic in a caravan. There was one where a balloon rolled to the window and you came into shot and grabbed it. And I found myself going, that poor balloon. What hope did it have? What a contrast in the two players as well, because they both said stop it at the end, but I think that the two stop its speak of the two individuals concerned.
Here are the two stop its.
Stop it.
Stop it!
No doubt about where most of the victims are going to be.
Yeah. I mean, that was a man who's been bursting one balloon every 1.5 seconds.
Did he hit the target?
He hit the target, as did Dara, so it's all about speed. Dara, 3 minutes 20 to burst 99 balloons. John, 2 minutes 29, you get 5 points! Just to summarise, it's 5 points to John, 4 to Dara, but unfortunately 0 to everyone else. I'm so sorry, Sarah.
Can I see a scoreboard, please?
We have joint leaders on 7 points. It's Dara and John.
Do you have a team task waiting in the wings?
Oh, yes, I do. But shut up, please.
Yo, yo.
Oof. Hello, Alex. What is it?
Yo, Sarah, can you smell that? It smells a bit mad in here.
Is it a bit pumpy?
A bit pumpy.
It smells in here because one of the contestants did something bad in here.
Mmm, I can tell. Did a little pumpy.
No.
We can't talk about it.
No.
But you'll find out.
Oof. God damn. God damn.
Hello, Dara.
Oh,
Alex. Hi. Hello, Fern.
Hi.
And hello, John.
Alex.
So we've got a feather and we've got a pillow.
Get this feather into the bath.
You must not touch the feather, and the feather must not touch the ground.
After the feather has left its cushion, it must not touch a single thing for more than 5 seconds in total.
It must not touch a single thing for more than 5 seconds in total. The cushion must not leave the lab.
If you make any mistake at all, Alex will blow his whistle and you must start all over again.
Fastest wins, finally. You must not say any words at any point from now on.
New to my vocabulary, Pompey.
Pompey, no. Me too.
Do you know Pompey?
No, I didn't know, but I do know it now.
We say Pompey in Scotland.
Yeah, I think it's northern in Scotland.
It has two meanings. It means farts, but it also means shagging.
It means shagging and farting. So if you said to a friend, what did you get up to last night? And they went, hoo, 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 I had a Pompey night. It could be tragic or glorious. Let's go.
OK, well, let's start with a team of three. It's my mates Daz, Jaws and Fez. Here we go.
Hello.
Put it back on the cushion on the table, please, John. That was 6 seconds on there. Please put it back on the cushion. Sorry about that. Feather has been in the dustpan for more than 5 seconds. Back we come. Oh, hi, Fern. Where have your teammates gone?
Oh.
Here they come. Ah, lots of plates. Have you lost a feather, Fern? That's a chicken. You know, it has feathers. Start again.
Let's talk about Feather Lossgate and how how you think you as a team coped with the loss of the feather.
I think we coped really well. There was a lot of resilience.
I don't know who lost it.
Was it? It might have been me.
Is it me?
It was one of us, anyway. You could feel Dara's anger radiating out of him.
I could feel it through the screen.
Yes. I remember thinking I'd come up with quite a good system with the system of endless plates, and that kept us going.
It wasn't a system of endless plates, there were 12 plates.
So grand. That's when I introduced the system.
OK, break time, but before we go, here's a video to solve the riddle, what waves and wets the bed every night? Welcome back to Taskmaster. Let's finish off the current team task, shall we, Alex?
It's a double thumbs up from me. They're trying to get a feather in the bath, but they can't touch it, the feather can't touch the ground, they have to take it in turns moving it, and nothing can hold it for more than 5 seconds. Also, they can't talk. Peace, at last. Only the team of two left, it's... An reaction, Sarah. Why does it smell so bad in here? What did you do? Are you looking for something on here? The leaf blower. Do you look in the shed? It's probably in there.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, here you go. Ah, the music. Said, build pipes leading to bath, question mark. It's on its way, is it? Stop the clock.
Well, I got there.
Did you enjoy Sarah finding the leaf blower?
I was about to say it was absolutely my highlight of the whole attempt. Look at her little face. What I wrote down is, anyone who thinks that that leaf blower is going to be good in this task is mad.
I thought that it was going to be hovering around and, you know, Sarah would be using the guitar to direct it.
That's what the guitar was for Sarah to just bat it in the right direction.
I was chief wafter. That's why I brought the plates in, because I had a similar idea to these guys, but then when you came in with the drain pipe and an excited expression on his face, and it's just, it's like, you know, it's like having a bay in, I imagine.
Yeah.
Where you're just like, look at his little face, OK, we'll play with the tubes.
So they did achieve the task.
They did achieve the task, but did they do it faster than these three clowns?
Well, the three clowns got the feather in the bath in 7 minutes 45.
Really?
Yeah.
What about the elaborate pipe system?
Oh, 24 minutes and 25 seconds.
Stupid plates, we wouldn't have had this problem.
I'll give them 2 points. I'll give the mighty team 5.
Whoa, OK, so it's 2 points to the team of 2, 5 points to the team of 3.
What's next, Horn?
Oh, it's a bouncy, bouncy, fun location task.
Hello.
This is enticing.
Make an exercise ball touch Bernard.
Bernard can't move. Who's Bernard?
You may launch an exercise ball from behind the line. What line there? And may not touch any balls after each launch.
Most balls actively involved in a successful launch wins.
Your task ends when a ball touches Bernard or 15 minutes have elapsed. I hope Bernard's a puppy or something.
Your time starts. Your time starts.
I don't know who Bernard is. Who is Bernard? Oh, damn.
It's a pretend man.
Do I get one attempt to release a ball?
As many as you want until you hit Bernard. All 15 minutes is up.
Whatever ball hits him, the more balls it's hit on the way, the better.
So I can move all the balls so that when I hit one ball, it did a da 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 poo.
I'm not sure why I've written this down, but I found Fern's description of Bernard as a pretend man.
It's what they put clothes on in shops, isn't it? Pretend men.
Yeah, of course. Get the assistant to put some pretend men out and display our clothes. Anyway, I think it's clear what we've got here. We've got a game of Bernard snooker, and anyone who doesn't understand it should just remember...
Okay, we're going to kick off with Fern, Sarah, and Dara.
We're going to have the green as the launch ball.
Lovely.
And I'm going to move the rest down.
Surely you just want to get all the balls going and hope for the best.
I think that's not a bad strategy.
Okay.
I think if I line them all up here, one of them's got to touch them, right?
Sounds good to me.
See the trick shot? I'm genuinely really, really excited about this.
He looks quite worse for wear. What's happened to him in other tasks? Why were this? Oh, it's because it's nowhere near the middle, idiot.
Oh, come on! Oh, come on!
That didn't hit Bernard.
That didn't work.
Did you see that?
No, it hit that wall. Gone too far the other way. Gone too far the other way. Hit off that. No. Not. Oh, 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 wait, 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 wait. Bernard! Bernard!
Take that, Bernard. Got a chance. Here it goes. You got two on the go. This is it.
Thank you.
Increasingly, I live to hear the victory noises that Dara O'Brien makes during any of our tasks. But I think the snooker one's my favourite so far. Finished! Have you got some stats you want to share?
Well, you saw Sarah involved 5 balls, Dara 8 balls, so they've both got scores on the board.
Fern, I'm going to ask you what your strategy was here.
I'm going to need you to tell me what that task was, because I don't know what that was.
Right, OK, so there was no strategy.
It was entirely haphazard what she did, but she did it.
Fern did get points,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, she got 4 balls involved. It hit Bernard within the 15 minutes. Everything's fine.
Fine. Enter part three. Not long until someone increases their chances of survival by owning Sarah Millican's escape hammer. See you soon. For the final part of the show, and we're in the middle of a task which involves gym balls.
I went to school with gym balls. But that wasn't his real name, it was his nickname because he had massive testicles. So, this task is like a giant snooker trick shot. They've got to try and hit Bernard Mannequin with one of 15 balls, launching just one of them from behind the start line. You can't touch the ball again once it's been released. And the most balls actively involved in a successful launch wins. Two people left, and their names are Munya and John.
OK, question. Could you be a human shield?
You can place me somewhere. I don't think I can be actively involved.
OK, I can place you somewhere. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
All right, then. Can you lie there on your side, like you're spooning? Like your big spoon. Papa Spoon Alex.
Right. Boom.
OK, good. Just stay like that.
No.
2 minutes, John.
Yeah.
That ball control.
Knock, 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 knock. Bang, bang, bang. John Virgo.
It really is just 40 seconds now, John.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Here we go. OK, it's on its way. Ah! Yes, that's a good throw. That is a very good throw. Right, Alex, get ready. OK, release. Yes! Look at all those hits.
Yeah.
It's the planning for me.
I grew up in the 70s where we weren't allowed to have self-confidence. And I really enjoy watching Munya always because he absolutely believes in himself. And by stark contrast, what I wrote down for John was shambles. But how wrong I was.
Yeah. He only had one attempt. He took 14 minutes 20 to set it up. And he believed in the system. You had to do it within the quarter of an hour, and he did it first time.
He set it up, and it worked an absolute treat.
Yeah. But Munya, as you saw, 15 balls. He laid them all out. It was wonderful. Do you want to see it one more time?
Yeah, I do. Incredible.
It's a good throw. That is a very good throw. Right, Alex, get ready. OK, release. 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 What you don't know can't hurt you.
So John gets the 5 points.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then Dara 4. Yeah. Sarah 3, Fern 2. And then Munya.
Yeah.
What are you going to do to him, Greg?
Give him no points.
No points. But 5 points goes to John Kern.
Okay, let's see a scoreboard, please, Alex.
Okay, they're all on double figures except for Munya, who's only got 3 points. John is in the lead with 17.
OK, everyone, please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show! Who will read the final task?
Sarah Millican.
Begin.
OK. Blow an item the furthest on the nappet. If your item falls from the nappet, you are disqualified. The person who blows something the least far each round is eliminated unless someone is disqualified. You must all select your blowers and items for each round before any blowing commences, and you must not use the same blower or item twice. Last player standing wins.
They each have a whiteboard, so on the whiteboard you need to write down the four things you want to blow and the four things you want to blow them with. You've got five items to blow, and that is a beach ball, an air ball, a golf ball, a ping pong ball, and a pea. You have five items to blow with. You've got some bellows, a recorder, a whoopee cushion, a straw, and just for you, Sarah Millican, a leaf blow. We're ready. It's Dara first.
All champion. Let's see, what he's, let's see if he's still got it.
Oh, that is lovely.
Textbook!
Fern, you're up next. John. Kearns is gone. Manya.
Oh, that's Pete.
That is Pete. Sarah Millican. It'd be awful if you choke on a recorder.
Yes.
Well, the peas have all made it through. Kearns is out. OK, round two.
Oh. Oh, he legislated for the banks, I think. Oh. Oh. All right, is it?
Is it though? That's tilting to the side. That tilts.
Sorry, fair.
Okay, Manya.
Do you want to just kick it like you did the ball the other time? Yeah.
Maybe try a few more ancestors. Oh, it's off. It's off.
Oh.
Oh. Hello. Yeah! Right then, Sarah.
Sick of blowing on balls.
That's it. That's yeah. It.
There we go. It's off.
It's chocolate. Yeah. The only one left standing. Come down, let's see how that the final score!
Good boy with points, good boy with answers.
Yes, well, Dara was the last player standing, and I think we can see his final puff one more time.
Oh, lovely.
What was that thing you said about the...
Because ball obviously went, because I'm blowing air at it.
I'm afraid, Dara, that all evidence points to the fact that you did make contact with the ball. That's the end of it.
So, because Dara has also failed round two, John gets 1 point, everyone else gets 5 points.
Wow.
I really need a
John Kearns was in the lead in this episode, but he came last in that task.
Oh, ahoy.
Yes, he's lost his tailor's hat. Dara Breen wins the episode with 21 points.
There it is! Dara Breen has won show 7. Please both up to the stage and collect your worthy prizes. So, what have we learned today? We've learned that if we're going to survive as a species, we need to put all of our faith in the younger generation. And we can, because of great people like Greta Thunberg and Malala, inspiring so many people around the globe. And Munya Chihuahua, of course, who drives around with one hand on the wheel with a balance game in the other, and who cheated at a bouncy ball gym task with a pretend man called Bernard. That's all for 7. But not all for tonight's winner, of course. It's Dara Breen!